In all honesty, I'm gonna ambulance. So, in all honesty, I wasn't thinking about it, but when I started talking about what I talk about in this video, I started talking all slow and kind of sound tired because I am tired. And when I'm not looking at myself, I start to slow down and talk a little quieter or whatever. I mean, you can still hear me clearly, but I'm going to sound very sleepy, and I'm sorry about that. Now, let's get on to the video. Oh, and your boy looking crispy, boy. I got tired of that caveman look. So I fixed it. All right, now to the video. For real this time. What up, it's your boy King Tank, and in this video, I'm gonna tell you what's the best thing to put on the gym when you wanna keep it. Now, a lot of people think what they putting on gyms is making it good for them to keep it, but truthfully, it's not. If you put the right Pokemon on gyms, that's if you have them. Because a lot of these are a lot more rare than what people are putting on gyms. The ones that are best at keeping them. But so, I'm going to tell you what it is, what you need, and what you should strive for. Let's get it. Alright, so, let's see. That was just a team listed gym. But of course, considering it's right next to where I go to college at, I had to destroy it. You know, hey, no beef. It is what it is. That's how the game goes. So, what I'm gonna tell you now is basically the reasoning for my list. I mean, for what the factor that I choose for most important when putting a Pokemon on a gym that you're trying to keep. And I'm gonna tell you why, and then I'm gonna show you the list of the best things you can use, and I'm gonna tell you which is best out of the best things you can use. So a lot of people go by CP, and I mean, I understand that considering the game makes CP the most important factor in placement, and it make it seem like it's the most important thing in the game. But the fact is even if you have a high CP Pokemon, if it's easy to take down, it's easy to take down no matter how high the CP gets. You can still wreck it. I mean, you can see me, sometimes I use like a 1200 Jolteon. I mean, I use something like 1200 to take something that's 2300 because it is what it is. It's not hard anymore. It's not hard if it's a weak Pokemon. All right, so the factor to me that I consider most when putting a Pokemon on a gym that I want to keep is HP. Now, if you want to keep a gym, having a strong Pokemon is good. Having high CP Pokemon is good. Best moveset, that's good. High IVs is good. All that stuff is good. But if you have a high HP Pokemon, odds are it's going to be the hardest for them to take down. Now, Exeggutor is not one of them. Exeggutor doesn't have naturally high HP. Now, something I found out is that when you put the list on HP, it doesn't work. It still goes by CP for some reason. I don't know why that is. Because if you go to him, his HP is 137, while that one HP is 199. So, you can't go by that. You have to actually go into each individual Pokemon and look at their HP. Hey, my gym Pokemon are in the diagonal. All right, sorry, I got distracted. But look, so the best thing to pay attention to is the HP. The higher the HP, the longer it'll last, and the harder it'll be to take down. Now I'm going to show you a list of Pokemon, which I consider, I mean, a list of Pokemon that have the highest HP in the game. Boom, just switch. Oops, wrong switch. So, switch on up to this. And I'm going to put a link to this in the description. But, so this website has a list, I mean, has a part where you can look at their base stats, their types, their capture rate, flea rate, everything. And what we're going to focus on right now is HP. So you put max HP from highest to lowest, top 20R, right here. I can close that now. That's the top 20. But considering Chansey is so weak, we're going to ignore that and just skip it. Now, so these are the best Pokemon to put on gyms. Now, the reason why I say HP, having higher HP would do you a lot better than paying attention to highest CP is for the simple fact that the higher the HP, the longer it's going to be fighting. The longer it's fighting, the more power it's going to take down. The more power it takes down, the less likely they are to survive all the way into the end. So, obviously, you can see some of the main things that everybody uses on this list. But some things that people use, some of the main things people use are actually not the best things to put. Consider Dragonite has one of the highest HPs in the game. I mean, have one of the highest CPs in the game, yet its HP is not all that high. Its max HP is only 149. That's not much. And so, especially if you're using something with a type advantage over him, then he's going to go down extremely fast. Yeah, so real talk is pointless. But best things to me to use, and what I consider the best things to put on the gym, is this top four right here. Main things that I feel will do the best when you're sitting them on the gyms: Snorlax, Wigglytuff, Lapras, and Vaporeon. Those are some of the best Pokemon in the game, and one of them gets slept on. Wigglytuff. Wigglytuff doesn't have some of the highest CP like some of the rest of these, but Wigglytuff, if you have Pound and Hyper Beam, is incredibly strong and incredibly hard to take down. Plus, normal types don't have, the only disadvantage for normal types is fighting types, and there's not much you can do with fighting types in this game. Power-wise, there's not many powerful fighting types or fighting type moves. So, the best things you can put is especially normal types. So, if you want to keep them, you want to keep a hold of those gems, you want to put something on it that's going to stay there, I mean, that's going to give their attackers the most problem. But a Snorlax, Wigglytuff, Lapras, or Vaporeon. Something else that is slept on that people don't put on gems much, I would say, is Muk. Muk is a pretty good defender, especially if you have his best moveset. Poison, most people don't know what counters poison, and a lot of people don't look it up. So a lot of times it won't get countered correctly, and that'll make it do a lot of damage to who it's attacking. And really, so that's one of the main reasons why that's something that's good to use. So truthfully, this right here, this shows you the main things that you should be putting on gems right here. The top 20, of course, not including the legendaries. And if you're not in Australia, not including Kangaskhan. I know this was kind of boring the way I was talking. Sorry, I'm kind of tired. But to me, that's the best way to hold down the gem is to use this. Now, this list has every Pokemon on it. You can go all the way down. Oops, comments and stuff. All the way down, and the lowest HP, of course, is Diglett. And right before him is Magikarp. But anyway, but that's how you can hold down the gym. And this app is a list. And this website has a list that's interchangeable, where you can go by CP, HP, base stats, types, capture rate, flea rate, attack timers, class, and even candy to evolve. So, this is a really good website to use for finding stats on all Pokemon, as well as the best things to use for trying to hold the gym down. So, you know who it is. It's your boy King Tank, and we got a shot for no reason. I'm out.